Hey everybody, I'm Jake, the Geek Out Tech, and today I'm going to talk to you about the basic layout of ScreenFlow's editing window. The editing window consists of three main panes: the canvas, the timeline, and the properties. The canvas displays all the visual elements of your project. The main part of the canvas is the preview, and that shows you what's actually going to end up in your final video. The gray area around the preview shows all the off-screen elements, such as text or images. And what's currently being displayed in the preview is dictated by what's called the scrubber, and that's the little red line down here in the timeline. Now, the timeline is a visual representation of your video through time. This includes all elements of the project, such as what you've recorded, anything you may have added to the project, such as images or audio clips, and it includes all the different manipulations that you can do to your project through the properties pane. Here in the properties pane, there are many different controls for altering your video. You can alter the video, the audio, there are a couple of other effects here on these different tabs. You can add text, and the one other thing is the media library. This is where you can import other media into your project, such as video clips, audio clips, images, and you can also add more ScreenFlow recording to your project. Now, there are a few other things to take note of that are outside the main panes. Up here on the top, you can name, rename your project. You can move the file to another location on the hard drive, duplicate the project, or lock the project. Another thing over here in the right corner is full screen mode. This is for anyone who has the operating system Lion or above. Click on full screen so you're not distracted by other things on your desktop. And just push your cursor up there and you can get out of full screen mode. And down here below the properties pane is a visual representation of the audio levels of your recording. It's in stereo, so you have your left and right speaker. Over here are the playback controls. You have your play and pause, skip to the end of the project, skip to the beginning of the project, and here's a time representation of where your scrubber is at in the project: hours, minutes, seconds, and frames. And one last thing over here on the left is the canvas controls, and I'll go over that in a future video. So that's the basic layout of the editing window for ScreenFlow 4. I'm Jake, the Geek Out Tech. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. It's the easiest way to support the channel. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.